Asama, dudes! Bago natin simulan, palakpak ka naman dyan sa mga solid 10,000 mad dudes nating nakasubscribe. But, anyhow, what I have for you today is isa na naman ulit di kalidad na motor na merong mas magandang features and has the same engine displacement and could potentially have the much higher output than the MT-03 with its optimizable engine. And not to mention na kasing bigat lang ito ng isang 150cc backbone. And this, my dude, is from the all-new Kolob Cobra 321 Single Siguro, my dude, first time mo palang marinig ang brand na ito. But ang totoo niyan is matagal na tayong meron yan. Which I'm sure napunood mo na sa mga motor ng mga sikat na motor vloggers natin dyan. Kasi, my dudes, ang Kolob Motorcycle ang mismong kumuha ng Brix Venturi 500 and the Veloci 500 ng Bristol Motorcycles. As you can see right here. And yup, these are Chinese manufactured bikes. O ngayong nakilala mo ng Chinese brand pala yung pinopromote ng mga idol nyo? Nagbago ba yung opinion nyo? Or perhaps it's the right time to at least learn to appreciate all kinds of motorcycle brands. But coming back to the Cobra 321 single, Actually, last year pa ito na-unveiled in the late 2020 Motor Expo in China as their new product lineup called Focus on Performance Models. Yup, this one is not your typical Chinese bike. Kagaya ng FKN 3GP, which by the way, kung hindi mo pa napanood, link in the description or in the pinned comment section below. The Cobra 321R also had gone through the same extensive development process, hardware adaption and optimization, and more. Para lang may mapakita silang proper representation of its actual test version. And as the name suggests, as you can see, incorporated siya mismo sa design. And I'm not really sure kung intended ba yan for aerodynamic purposes or just for aesthetics. But nevertheless, I'm sure first impression nyo dito is parang pinaghalong old school KTM Duke and CF Moto and K250. Not sure kung sangkot dito ang designer ng Kieska, but overall it's a buff up lightweight looking bike. And as for its features, it's got an all LED light, full color TFT display and a dual channel ABS as standard, paired with a readily mounted 4 piston 320mm single disc brake at the front and a 240mm at the rear. Tire size are 110/70/17 and a 150/60/17. Mated with a KYV inverted forks and another single rocker swing arm. Oh yeah! And about its fuel tank capacity is around 13 liters, which will get you an estimated 300 kilometers of fuel range. So, my dudes, as for its engine specs, it's got a 322cc 4-stroke, 8-valve, dual overhead cam, liquid cooled with Bosch electronic fuel injection. And a boring stroke of 68 by 42.2mm is the main reason kaya meron siyang identical power figures with the MT-03. That's around 41 horsepower at 10,500 RPM with the maximum 29.6 Nm of peak torque at 9,000 RPM. You might say na baka. Kinopia yung mismong makina ng MT-03? Well, in a way. But ang makina ng Cobra 321R ay galing sa Longines Motorcycle with its KE350 engine platform. And with its same displacement and boring stroke, it's pretty much will sound and behave like the MT-03. And yes, this is not the first time na nagkaroon sila ng same engine setup ng Big 4. In fact, kung natatanda nyo yung review ni Sir Zach with the Brix Venturi 500 and the Veloci 500, is pareho lang din ang engine configuration niya sa Honda CB500X. But what really separates this bike with the MT-03 is how the heck they managed to attain the overall weight of just 147kg. Holy guacamole! That is not something you could pull up without research and years in development. Gaya ng paano ka maglalagay ng internal components na lalong pinaliit at mas pinagaan. Gaya ng air filter without sacrificing intake efficiency. Or paano pagkakashin ang lahat ng yan without increasing the overall width ng frame? And once they figure it out, they end up having a frame width of just 14 kg and another 4.8 kg for the single rocker swing arm. Nagbawas din sila from its very first test unit na dating naka-dual disc brake setup. As for the top speed performance is ayon sa claim ng Colob is meron daw itong 180 kilometers per hour na top speed and a 100 kilometers per hour in just 6 seconds. At ayon sa kanila is kaya pa daw nilang i-optimize ang max power output ng makina. Which I'm not sure kung ilalabas nila sa final production commercial unit or just an update in the future. But all I can say my dude is eto na siguro yung Chinese bike na masasabi kong kaya na talaga makipagsabayan sa mga Japanese bikes. Especially in the power to weight ratio is mahirap talagang talunin yan. So what about its release date? Actually this March 2021 na yan, in China. Syempre later on na lang yan if ever pumasok sa atin. And with an estimated price range of around 27,000 to 30,000 Chinese yuan. But for my own estimated guess, price niyan sa Pinas perhaps nasa 15 to 25,000 pesos less than the MT-03 ng Yamaha. Kasi wala nang ibang maglalabanan dyan in this category and price. Since these two are basically twins on papers. Kung gusto mo pa ng solid information whether this bike will be available in the Philippines, why not go ask Bristol Motorcycle Philippines and see for yourself. Kasi sila lang naman na maglalabas niyan sa atin or pwede din sa Motostrada. Alam niyo ba mad dudes kung bakit? Limited lang for the sub 150cc category ang mga bagong pumapasok sa bansa natin? And why? Bakit? Kakarampot lang yung mga 200 to 350cc option natin is dahil sa lumang sistema na meron tayo sa Pinas. Isa na dyan yung 20-year-old rule for the 400cc big bikes. Now I'm not saying na dapat buksan yan para sa lahat. Kasi gaya nga ng sabi ni Dude Kian is yan. And sa akin lang is at least gawa nila ng update yung system. Kasi 20 years ago pa yung basihan nila na kung saan ang current 300 or even 250cc bikes natin ngayon is now well capable of producing the same or even more horsepower than the 400cc bikes from 20 years ago. As long as ganito pa rin yung sistema natin, hindi tayo magiging target market for the sub 250 and 350cc bikes. Na kung saan ito yung mga lumalabas ngayon na bagong units. In almost every month, merong bago or nasa development stage. Gaya na lang netong Benda VTR 300 that comes with a turbocharged engine. Syempre, big bikes are still the best. But with the innovation and advanced technological aspect that we currently have today is just too much for the street. That is why meron silang riding aids na kasama. Hindi naman tayo mga MotoGP riders that can push a big bike at its limits. That's why for me very sensible itong mga general sub below 400cc bikes. It's cheap, lightweight, easy to maintain and has enough usable power for the street. At panghuli, pakipindot naman ang subscribe button dyan, my dude. Kung nagustuhan mo yung content natin kasi ang laki ng mga hindi pa nakasubscribe dyan. Para sa'yo, simpleng pindot lang yan. Pero ang totoo yan, napakalaking tulong yan, my dude, to support this channel.